And I sincerely want to say that I apologize, that I've done something to upset the people of Baltimore, that I love, care about, and work hard every day for.
All right, the mayor says she's sorry, so is it over? Obviously, there's a lot of political damage. Thiru Vignarajah joins me now, former Deputy Attorney General of Maryland, former federal prosecutor and clerk for Justice Breyer. Great to have you on, as always. We know that there's political damage here, but what about, is there any legal exposure that you see at this point right now for the mayor?
You know, it's hard to say with any definitive confidence, in part because Mayor Pugh has said so little publicly. But it does look like there's a lot of different angles of criminal exposure. Last week, there was a referral to the Office of the State Prosecutor about failing to properly fill out mandatory disclosure forms, which are completed under penalty of perjury. This is the same thing that ended up resulting in criminal charges against the superintendent of schools in Baltimore County. Last week, I also wrote a piece to the Baltimore Sun identifying a number of additional angles and questions he needs to answer, questions about tax fraud, about campaign finance violations. There's a lot more to answer here, and I think the mayor's strategy of, dismissing this as a witch hunt or just apologizing and not answering any questions is not going to serve her well.
What about her hiding behind the lawyer, saying, my lawyers told me not to answer any questions on it because this is under a criminal investigation because there was a complaint that was brought forward? Does that hold water with you?
You know, I think it's fair, and I actually probably think it's good advice from her lawyers. If her lawyers have not told her that there is real criminal exposure here, they're not doing their job. You know, how much you reported on those taxes as income depends on how much her printing expenses were. But we don't know her printing expenses. We don't know if these books were in fact printed. And until she gets confidence around that, until she can give her lawyers confidence about that, and they can answer authorities on those questions, which are the first set of questions she's going to get, I actually think it's probably good advice that she not say more. But it puts us in a real jam because we need confidence in our leaders, especially at this moment of crisis. And she does appear very distracted.
We're talking with Thiru Vignarajah, former Deputy Attorney General of Maryland and a former federal prosecutor. So who's investigating now then? I mean, we know this complaint has been brought forward. Do we know who's looking into this deal, and what exactly are they looking at?
We don't know, and it would be speculation for me to surmise who might be doing this. I can suggest which authorities have jurisdiction over this. So the Office of the State Prosecutor certainly has primary jurisdiction over criminal charges involving public officials. That's why the referral has happened to them. The comptroller has tax investigative powers. Here in the state, federal prosecutors have jurisdiction over federal tax forms. You're going to ultimately have to deal with the state of Board of Elections with respect to whether or not there's been campaign finance violations, although those are ultimately referred, again, back to the Office of the State Prosecutor. When you give a nonprofit like the University of Maryland can't give money directly to a campaign, it would violate their nonprofit designation. But those same laws also prohibit you from giving money to an LLC to then give money to a campaign. And that seems to be what the mayor has acknowledged happened with Healthy LLC. They got money from the university and then they turned around and gave it to multiple political campaigns, including a $5,000 contribution of their own.
Right.
So I think there's questions to be asked by a lot of different authorities.
So are these entities that you talked about, like the comptroller and the IRS, are they free to just look into that and investigate themselves? Do there have to be some kind of probable cause for it? Are they allowed to look at media reports and say, hey, that kind of smells, I'm going to go look at that? What's the process on that?
It's a good question. I mean, to initiate an investigation, you need to have a reasonable basis and a good faith basis. I think both of those exist here. It's not like somebody has to formally complain for you to investigate, you know, drug dealing in a particular neighborhood. If you see some evidence of it, a good faith basis is sufficient. Here, we have a nonprofit giving money to a LLC in the name of the mayor, which then gave money to the mayor. That's a good faith basis for one kind of investigation. You have her indicating what her taxable income is, but no evidence that there are any expenses or at least dramatically reduced expenses, given the number of books that would need to be produced, that would be a reasonable basis to initiate an investigation. It's ultimately the prosecutor's prerogative to decide when and if that's appropriate. But I think, you know, what I point out in my piece to the Baltimore Sun last week is it's appropriate at this stage for those authorities to start asking those questions, and frankly, for the mayor to start focusing on being ready to answer those questions.
All right, last question before I let you go. What about the University of Maryland medical system? Are they in any legal trouble? And the other board members who did similar things as the mayor and got these either no-bid contracts or competitive contracts with the University of Maryland medical system?
You know, I think that they have survived or had less exposure in terms of public scrutiny, in part because, you know, the UMMS CEO has at least taken a leave of absence. I think they should be asking similar questions as well. They need to get to the bottom of who approved this deal, what the circumstances were, whether the mayor was sponsoring legislation that aided them, and whether or not they knew about that. A very small number of people knew about this deal, and we need to know why and what the circumstances were for the lack of public disclosure. It's a real blemish on a terrific medical system, and they need to get to the bottom of this as well. And I think pinning the blame, frankly, entirely on the mayor is irresponsible as well. She certainly has her share of responsibility as well.
All right, Thiru, great stuff. Really appreciate you coming on the show.